If you've ever been out to a bar, house party, or club and you decided not to drink, someone probably asked you, hey, why aren't you drinking? And that's okay because they're probably just wanting to include you or wanting to know why you're not doing what everybody else is doing. And I found it was really hard to answer at first until I learned a few tricks. So I'm gonna teach them to you here. So you've got two options. You can answer it quickly and move on to something else. And that's great if you're like there to have fun with your friends and party and like get a little crazy. Or if you wanna have an in-depth discussion with someone and really share why you don't or share your point of view, then you can go the long road and you can actually explain it to them. But it's important to know what you want first before you decide how you're gonna respond. The first one, you can just say, I'm driving tonight, or I'm driving people home, I'm the designated driver. And people give you mad props for that. They might say like, oh, thank you, that's so awesome. Or, oh, cool, can I get you anything from the bar, like a Coke or anything? But people are really supportive. And I really love it too, because if you go to a bar and you just tell the person at the bar that you're the designated driver, oftentimes you'll get your Coke or your water or a Sprite, you'll get it for free. Another thing you can do is just say, I've gotta wake up early tomorrow. Now, this works easily because nobody knows what early is. Early for you could be 5 a.m., it could be 11 a.m. Nobody cares. It means, hey, I'm not drinking because I gotta wake up early for a game, I'm gonna study, I have a test. It doesn't matter, but it's an easy excuse and it works a lot of the time. The only danger is if somebody asks you, oh, what are you waking up for? Then you might have to tell them what you're gonna do in the morning, or how early are you waking up? I wake up at 4, and they wanna challenge you. Then you'll have to learn how to deal with that. The third way is to say, my stomach's been acting a little weird lately. This works because nobody wants to see you throw up and they actually care that you feel good that night. They offer you a drink because they want to make you feel included. So they're not going to make you want to feel sick. It's an easy one to use. And stomachs are weird anyway, like it's a crazy organ. So I don't think it's too big of a lie if you don't feel like you're gonna throw up to say, my stomach's a little weird. You can use it. The main thing to keep things quick is to never ever say, I don't drink. That is gonna open up a huge can of questions. So you can say that. You can say, I don't drink, but just know that's not gonna get you the quick ending that you want. So use those three if you want a quick way to kind of diffuse the question, and then immediately ask them something else. Change the subject, talk about a show you watch, or pick something you both might like to start moving towards that way. Now, if you'd actually like to talk with that person more about your decision, maybe you're good friends and you want to get to know each other more, go ahead and have that conversation. Tell them, hey, I don't drink, if you don't, you know, or if you're on a sports team and it's important to you to be sober during the season, whatever it is, go ahead and share that. Just be prepared that they're gonna ask questions and it'll be cool for you guys to get to know each other a little better because you're gonna share those things together. So these were just a few examples of how you can answer the question, why aren't you drinking? But if you have something that works, go ahead and leave it in the comments. I'm sure everybody would love to hear it. And then, of course, if you like this content, you wanna hear more sober tips, make sure to subscribe. And we'll see you next week for another video.